for wow, from the cradle to the grave, kid.
You just saw me hit 640 pounds for a single on squat, and we have a second time visitor, Nick Ryan, onto my channel. I think you're on my channel like 2 years
ago. Way back, Arnold Classic.
Yeah.
It was like Arnold Classic 2015 or something like that. Yeah. We tried to squat, there weren't enough plates, so then we benched. And then by then we were so drained that the bench didn't even go well.
It's always hard training like at events where like everyone's kind of like in town, because it's just hard to get like plates, it's hard to get weights, it's hard to get like a proper vibe to work out.
We couldn't even get past three plates.
Yeah, but you were here originally for Max's deadlift event, right?
Yeah, I competed in deadlift for Duke.
Yeah.
That was cool.
Hey man, I was judging him, I was gonna give him that red light, but
I sucked my $5 deadlift beforehand, so.
Yeah, so we're like, you know what man, next time you come into town, let's go ahead and get a training session in.
Yeah,
so today we're hitting squat. Nick, you hit, but first of all, like, let the people know what you're going through right now. All right,
so I'm 4 weeks into my contest prep. I'm 8 weeks out from a bodybuilding show, doing Christian's show. So I'm not peaked for strength at all.
Yeah.
My all-time best when I was 550, but I'm training with Russ, and you can't be weak around Russ. So he motivated me to pretty much match that. I worked up to 545. At a body weight of 180 right now, mid-diet and unpeaked, so
yeah,
that's like around 3 times body weight.
Yeah, bro, that's impressive. Like, I don't think you guys understand, when you come inside of the gym unpeaked and also you're cutting, like you're cutting for an actual bodybuilding show, you're gonna lose strength. And for him to hit 540 or 545, that's like what, 5 pounds under your max? Or,
yeah.
That's hella impressive. That's really impressive. That's crazy, honestly. So, yeah.
Yeah, thanks, man.
Now we're about to do some volume shit. I don't want to do it. I'm not going to lie to you guys. I kind of want to go home right now. Whenever you do, like, whenever you work up to certain weights, like, you have your single, right? That's kind of like the peak of your workout. You're like, bro, today was a good-ass day. And then, like, you're about to, like, unrack the weight. You're like, oh, shit, I got, like...
Yeah, like, you're done. Like, adrenaline spent.
Yeah, exactly.
You're amped up. And it's like, how exciting is sets of eight?
It's not. It's not at all.
That's like cardio.
So, like, what do you... You're not about to do, like, cardio, right?
I'm not doing eight. I'll do some sets of four.
Gotcha.
Just to, like, support you.
Yeah, so he gets to pick and choose what he needs to do. But I have to follow, like, this fucking peaking program. So, this is going to be the first set of eight. It's going to be 535 pounds. Last week, you guys saw me hit 550 for a set of 10. But we're going to go
550 for a set of 10. Can I just pause you for a second? My max for a set of 10. That's unreal. But honestly, no lie, I'm getting, like, ADD here. But that's why I was able to hit anything heavy today.
Yeah.
Seriously, you train with the best in the world in your sport, it's motivating as hell.
Second best.
We're going up for round two to retest that this year. It'll be good.
Yeah. But yeah, man, it's always fun to lift with people that kind of understand the vibe of like powerlifting and shit like that, because it allows you to get pushed. And like, I don't know if I would have hit 640 today for today's workout, because I kind of walked in dragging. But I saw Nick, I was like, bro, I gotta put on a little bit for the homie. So okay, so cool. This is gonna be the first set, 535 for a set of eight at an RP of 6-7.
Same.
Sheesh.
Oh, easy. I'm good. Oh, good. Come on.
Let's go.
Oh, this is my jam.
Overall, man, what would you say about the workout?
10 out of 10.
10 out of 10?
It's pretty good. You're getting better. Soon you'll be up to my squat.
So you're literally dipping here to go back to the hotel and then eventually head out to the airport.
Shooting to the hotel. I'm going to change. We already checked out, so it's in the lobby. So I've got to change clothes. I'll wash my face in the bathroom and then just got to hit the airport.
Gotcha. Your flight's at?
It's at 5 o'clock.
5 o'clock.
But it's at the faraway airport, so we got to leave by like 2:30.
It's probably like 45, probably almost an hour drive out.
For real, this was fun and stuff. This was the workout I was looking the most forward to. Me and Russ both do the same thing in powerlifting.
Yeah.
And being able to train with top one in the country, top two, up for debate soon.
Yo, stop saying top two, man. I'm getting tired. No, but I think it was fun to work out, because like here there's not a lot of powerlifters.
Nah.
I would say. So it's like mostly like bodybuilders, and it's cool to get someone that actually knows like powerlifting and stuff like that to work out, because it's more motivating. But I liked how you got to pick and choose the weight that you're doing, or the amount of reps that you're doing. I had to do eights. You're just really doing fours and sixes and shit.
I'd do a minimum of four, a maximum of eight, and then I just decide how supportive I wanted to be of you. So I decided to be a little supportive with sixes.
But dope. Once again, this is Nick Wright, man. You guys have seen him on my channel before. His link will be in the description box, like always. So I appreciate you coming
Thanks,
out,
dude.
Man.
Appreciate you linking up.
I was about to bring you in, but I was like, I still got my camera.
We'll do it again.
Yeah, we still doing that. You see it? We still out here.
Joe Biden question.
What do you think of Simone being his...
I think that was a really good look for the Biden camp.
The next day.
Oh, alright, I just made it back from the gym. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I actually did not... I mean, I filmed what I did, obviously, but I wasn't... Like, what I did inside the gym was very unassuming. Like, today I had a 3x7 with a soft touch-and-go bench. It just was not impressive enough for me to, like, actually go through the workout with you guys and explain what was going on. I actually had a pretty shitty day today. And I don't know what it was. It's whatever, but I want to focus on the fact that I will be loading up on calories going into tomorrow's deadlift session, because tomorrow, it's not like a crazy heavy deadlift session. It's just an RP of 6, which is like going to be the top single, and then we have a 3x7. But I want to fuel up for tomorrow's workout. I've been weighing pretty low, so I can play around with just eating a lot more food. So what I'm going to be eating right now is my post-workout meal, which is my ground turkey combo. You guys already know the deal. Ground turkey with jasmine rice and mixed vegetables. We have broccoli in there. We got corn, carrots, peas, and mushrooms as well. I love vegetables, so I just throw in a shit ton of things. When I'm eating this meal, it's currently 6:30. Then after that, I'm going to go to Chipotle, load up on a lot of sodium. That's gonna be kind of like a cheat meal in a sense. But I'm gonna eat a full thing of Chipotle, like a full load of bowl with a bag of chips and all that stuff. And I'm sure that's gonna put me, just with the sodium alone, that's probably gonna add on another 2 pounds. So I'll probably weigh in at 191 to 192 pounds tomorrow. I did weigh in at 190 this morning, and that's perfectly fine. I'm exactly where I wanna be. So I'm gonna load up for tomorrow's deadlift session and actually stop by a shirt printing place, and I'm getting some new shirts printed out, and I wanna show you guys. Like, I'm not gonna show you guys the design, but the type of shirt that I'm gonna be putting together is like something of the acid wash type of vibe here. I'm sure you guys cannot see it. So the shirt that I'm getting is an acid wash shirt, and I'm gonna put a dope design on it. I think it's gonna be the last design that I'm gonna add on to this launch. It was very last minute, but I was sitting there talking to them, and I think it will be a good addition to the GBT launch that's gonna be most likely next Saturday. So next Saturday is May, let me see. Next Saturday is May 18th, so that will most likely be the next Get Better Today launch. They're telling me all the shirts are gonna be ready by the end of this week or the start of next week, and that's ample time to get like pictures and stuff like that. This shirt is most likely going to be coming, like with the design. I'm sure I'm gonna get the design tonight, so I'll show you guys the design that I'm gonna be putting as a badge on this particular acid wash shirt, and I think it's gonna come out really dope. So they have mineral, great. Oh man, I think it's gonna look great. So I'm super excited about that. But let me eat this meal, then later on go to Chipotle and enjoy this little influx of calories that I have.
3 hours later.
Can you move it along? I'm all out of time cards.
Okay guys, so it is about, it's been about 3 hours. I picked up Chipotle, got a bag of chips right here, and then I'm now watching the Golden State and Rockets game. This is gonna be a really good game, bro. Really, really good game. All right, so Chipotle and then Rockets game.
To Thompson, hemmed in, stapled in, threw the ball away, loose and picked up by Looney, and to Thompson, the hesitation and the two.
I gotta put my headphones on for this, man. This music is, it's not like deadlift type of music, you know what I'm saying? Luckily, we got the GBT playlist on iTunes, and I'll put it on shuffle right now. And then I know you guys ask me all the time about the headphone covers. These are Beat Kicks. You can get them on protectyourbeats.com. Use my discount code RussWolf. But we're just gonna go ahead and get this workout in. Like, I'm just gonna grind. Like, today is supposed to be a single RP of 6, pretty easy. Then we have sets of 8 at an RP of 6 to 7. So this workout should be relatively fast, and it should be relatively smooth. I did carb up, as I mentioned earlier on in the video, to make this workout as smooth as possible. So, not much to say, just, you know what I'm saying? Take that, yeah, straight to the face and get this workout underway. Bro, come on, man.
You struggling?
Yeah, don't you hate this stupid thing right here? What is the purpose of this?
To make it stay fresh, I guess.
Yeah. I'm over here trying to get hype. I can't even take my free ride. Alright, here we go.
music is sick.
I'm literally posting on Instagram right now about how sick this music is, man. I'm literally typing "you're sick" if this is your vibe at the gym. Yeah. Ew. This is nasty. So this is like the trick, right? This is always like my dilemma whenever I'm working up to a heavy single that's like supposed to be easy. So that's like essentially my last warm-up set. That was 585, and once again, it moved easily. Now it's like trying to figure out, damn, this music's loud as hell. Bro. Anyways, it's like figuring out what jump is next. So 585 moved pretty smooth. I might put on some 20, okay, I'm gonna put 650 on the bar. If that moves way too easy, I'm just gonna go seven plates. So 650 pounds should be the single. But once again, if it just moves like stupid easy, then I'm gonna put the weight back up to 675. So 650, top single, RP of six, then drop down, probably do like 565 for the 3x8 on deadlift. Yeah, that's top set. That was like 6.5. Shit. So that 650, it's so funny. Like I have to keep looking at the footage after I finish every single single to make sure that it's moving the way it needs to. Cause like when I'm picking it up, it feels like shit. But when I go back and look at the footage, I'm like, oh, it's not that bad. So like 650, it moved at like an RP of six. So I'm gonna go ahead and drop the weight down to probably like 565. Last week, I tried to do a little bit too much and ended up not completing the set the way I should have completed it. So I want to compensate with that by staying in the pocket for today's workout, like completely. So 565, three sets of eight, RP of 6-7. Great news. Great news. It's actually a 3x7. One less rep. That's better. It moved great, don't get me wrong. Just volume, man. We're starting to get into that, into those prep feels. Like I'm literally about like 5.2 weeks out. So we're starting to get to that point where you guys are gonna be seeing me inside of the gym with my singlet on. That's how close we are to competing. So today's May 9th. This is a classic, by the way. It's May 9th today. I compete next month on the 13th. So it's 5.4 weeks out. Sheesh. Hands are slowly starting to rip. Hopefully they don't rip on the next set. It'll be all right. We're done with the workout. That wasn't too bad. I think with peaking, for those of you that don't know, as you get closer to meet, you're peaking. And weight starts to feel heavier than it really is. The fatigue is higher because the volume is up, but very satisfied with how I knocked out today's workout. Stayed in the pocket, 650 single, then a 3x8 with 565 pounds. I can't be too mad at that. And this is after I squatted 640 2 days ago on Tuesday with Nick. So I'm very satisfied how this workout turned out. But I got some stuff that I gotta take care of outside of the gym. But I'll catch up with you guys later.
Okay, we're ending the video right here. Let me, I know I always send this, I say like I'm gonna end the video right here and then it goes on for like another 3 minutes, but I promise you guys, this is gonna be the whole conclusion of this video. What I wanna talk about, which is very short, is the fact that, once again, like we are 5.2 to 5.3 weeks out from IPF Worlds, which is like the biggest meet that I'm gonna be doing this year. And you know, I'm gonna be traveling to Sweden to get it done. I'll leave June 9th, which is a month from now. So 4 weeks from now, I will be traveling to Sweden. That's crazy, because today's May 9th. May 9th and then June 9th. So it's May 9th and then a month from now, which is gonna be June 9th, I will be on my way to Sweden to compete at IPF Worlds on June 13th. So we are, it's almost there. It's almost there. So what I wanna say before I end this video is that I put in one final shirt design, and I'm gonna show you guys exactly what it is here. So I am going to be doing another badge tee. Hopefully it shows here. I don't even know how people make it show, but hopefully it shows. I'm gonna be doing another badge tee here. It is, maybe I'll just put the design up on the screen. But anyways, it's Get Better Today, established 2015, very simple design. And what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna be putting it on a vintage acid wash t-shirt. It's gonna be mineral black, I believe that's the color, right? And it's gonna be on the left breast here, and then it's gonna be blown up on the back. It's gonna look dope. It's gonna look super dope. I don't even know what I'm trying to explain to you guys. You guys can't see it. You guys don't see the vision. But once I print it out on the shirt and everything, it's gonna be looking dope. So after my workout, I went to the bank to get the check to go to the t-shirt company and make sure I placed the order and all that stuff. So I should be getting it next week. And I'm like 2 seconds away from just declaring May, I think it's 16th, right? What the exact date is next week. So next week will be, yeah, I'm like 2 seconds away from declaring May 18th, the official day of the Get Better Today launch. I just need to literally get those things in my hand and that's when I'm gonna say it. So that's pretty much it for today's video. Man, we're just counting down the days, man. Just counting down the days. There's only a couple more deadlift sessions left. There's only a couple more squat days left until I'm actually stepping on that platform to compete for real, for real. So shout out to Nick Wright once again for collabing on this video. Shout out to Sweet Sammy. I purchased one of her shirts. I saw like a person wearing it and I was like, where'd you get that shirt from? They directed me to Sweet Sammy. I was like, yo, Sweet Sammy, let me call one of these things. So it's like, you know, the pre-workout made me do it. I think it was really dope and I chopped it up, cut it up, and that's pretty much it. So let me know if you guys want me to teach you how to cut shirts. I've showed you in a video and I had a couple questions asking me like, how did I cut this shirt? It's a really easy process. I should have took you guys through the process, but I didn't know that I'd get a lot of people asking me through IG and Twitter. So thank you guys for watching today's video. Like always, if you guys like today's video, please like, comment, share, and subscribe. Get better today. I'm out.
I stop your ass like a stop sign. Stop. Beat a little nigga up if he my side. Yeah. Fuck that Glock on his ass, now he cock-eyed. So. Numbers high over there, low on my side. Guaranteed to make any trap boom. Boom. We can't fuck it.